Hi there folks, as you can see, Mum and her snow baby are doing well. I sent the other piece off just in case because things were somewhat deteriorating on me. Right now, let me just pick up where I left off. I was talking earlier about the possibility of adding a little bit of a Christmas tree in there. It was getting a little bit cluttered in the background there. Look, that tree was mimicking this tree over there, unless I brought it down much closer. I could have possibly bring it in, let's say, round about there. That would be one way of getting that distance. I'm still looking at the distance there. I've now come up with another possibility, and I did ask you, but nobody seems to have come up with any fresh ideas on this one. What do you give a snow baby for Christmas in its Christmas stocking? Well, I've thought about that, and I've come up with a solution. I'm going to put a stick into the snow, which is going to be quite nice because this is rather plain down in this area. Okay, I broke it up just there, but I've done a little tracing. In fact, I've done two or three little tracings, and look, I can move it around until I've got it in the position which I want, and I can now, no point in having a Christmas tree and a Christmas stocking. So look, I love that sparseness of the background there, uncluttered. So I can decide where I'm going to put this stick, and I can add a little bit of colour down in this corner down there. So I'm going to take that opportunity and I'm going to paint this in, and if things go a little bit wrong for me, and they can still do so, little bit more information here, that new high-tech Wi-Fi camera, yes, it will talk to the phone. It is a wonderful thing, but I've spoken to my WizKid grandchildren and to the manufacturer, and there is no way it can actually film while looking through a monitor. And as you know, I don't have a camera crew behind me. There's just you and I sitting here, so I can't see what is going on behind me, so I cannot work without a monitor. So I'm going to have to sort that one out, because I cannot keep the painting and this close hand work in focus. That's the technical side of that. Let's go back to this area here. If things go a little bit wrong on me, I will possibly speed paint this piece, because you know what I'm thinking. I wish I did. I'm going to get this through one way or another, and then when I've done that, I'm going to start looking at the possibility of enhancing what I've already got. So let me concentrate my mind on this section first. Hopefully you will see me paint it, because you have seen every single nook and cranny and brushstroke since this conception of this idea came up. And for those who are just joining us here, you've arrived a little bit late. What I've been doing is I've been giving birth to a visual birth to that which was no more than an idea when I started, and I've winged it. In other words, I have done no rehearsals, and by that process, it might be a first for YouTube tutorials, because you have really watched me struggling here. Not just sorting the actual painting out, I've had a few camera gremlins, fruit flies, and a cold, which I'm still suffering from. But I'm going to take my lozenges and I'm going to move on forward. I have now traced my little twig, into the snow. Now, no, look, this is the advantage of having this temporary card mount. I didn't want the stick growing out of the card mount or dropping down behind it, so I've positioned it so that it's just above the card mount. Just a little detail, but I do have this eye for detail. I have now got on my palette a little bit of umber, just a little bit of sienna. Look, I'm not over mixing them. I've also got a yellow and I've got a green. And I'm going to work my way up that twig. Now, do not panic if you do not have such a steady hand. I might have a steady hand, but I do not necessarily any longer have that steady eye. And I'm gonna come back to you on this one in a moment. Let's get this twig underway first. And if need be, you just, you can always do this with a pencil. Now I've just touched my brush into that yellow and green. And the reason for that is because this is holly, and the younger twigs, and look, I'm deliberately making them slightly twisty because I don't want a straight stick. And look, I'm going back to an old technique which I used on my tree, my bare tree. And I'm allowing the puddle to drop back where the little twig is actually joining. It creates interest and is in actual fact true. You'll always get that little tiny bit of shadow where two branches come together. Look, I know I'm only doing a twig, but I'm still teaching. There we go. I think that is really about it. And the camera's still, I can hear the camera hasn't switched off. That doesn't mean to say it hasn't got, that it has got sound on it. There we go. Now what I need to do is to plant that into the snow. I'm going to cut this clip, see if I got sound on it. Yep, that last clip was okay. Look, I'm now picking up a little bit of bright red, cadmium red. And I'm just going to pop these berries. Check there's no drip of water on there. And look, I know this is taking me extra time. Look, although my hands are very steady, I don't just do that. I use my other hand to hold this one steady, because look, now instead of just being on that piece, I've now got a firm base on which I can just, he says, now let's zoom that in close. So you know what I'm doing. It's quite a strong bit of colour I've got there. Look, the brush is clear. I'm now holding. It got me again. I was about to say, if you get yourself one of these brushes, when you come to your pan, do not go scrubbing away at your colour there, because you will ruin that brush within a day. So pop a little drop of water on it and then just gently pick it up. And the same will apply if you've got an old tube and it's gone a little bit dry. Do not suddenly go poking your brush down in that hole there and scrubbing around, because that will ruin your brush. And leaving it in your jar of water, so the hair's bent, that will also ruin the brush. So you must treat this little tiny brush with great care. Having said that, if it is a little bit dry, look, I can just plonk a drop of water on there. I can always plonk just a little drop of water in my tube. And if it's got an air bubble on top, just break the air bubble and it will go through. Sorry, I haven't got my glasses on now. You just break that little puddle. Failing that, just take the top off and leave it soaking in a jar of water. Don't go and put them all in there, because you'll contaminate all the colours. So one colour, one jar, or one cup, whatever. Just plonk it in there without the lid on it, and it will help to revive the dried paint inside. End of. Right, folks, a remake here, because the gremlins gobbled up my holly berries. But there's plenty more where they came from. I have now got my yellow and green, and look, I will push the two together. I'm not going to over mix them, and I'm going to go down to the holly leaf and there we go. I'm not going to make a big fuss of this, but even on this I'm allowing a drop, a little puddle drop. Not sure if you can see that. And in this case I will allow the puddle drop to drop back in the direction of the berries there. Failing that, you will end up with not just a white hole, but a green hole. I just need to check that. Yes, the camo was okay. So I'm just going to put this final little one in. And if you want to, I mean, say this is getting really fussy now, but if you want that to be sharp, just use a pencil for the little spikes on there. Right, that's all dropping back quite nicely. So there's my holly. Shall I get a little bit of extra green just behind the berries? I think so. So just a little suggestion. Doesn't have to be a leaf as such. Just a suggestion there. And note, I am keeping my brush very upright because I don't want it skidding around there. I want it to kiss it and drop its little wet kiss onto the paper and then just steer it in the direction I wish it to go. When I'm talking about going down on this small brush, another thing which I use when I used to do my miniatures is that I would sit very, very quietly and just allow my mind to clear. And I've never had a monitor put on me, but I think my breathing and my heart rate drops to a point where I'm very steady on what I'm doing. And that's why I was saying the other day, look, if you only just put the bins out, do not come back and attempt this sort of thing. Right, now I've got a new problem here. And because this was not pre-planned, very difficult to get watercolours back over the top of that shading which I put on there. So, put my glasses back on. What I'm proposing to do off camera is, look, I'm just going to drop that puddle of water on the areas I wish the watercolour to go, and I will attempt to lift some of that colour off. I won't lift it all off. So I've now got a choice. Depending on how much colour I manage to lift off, the watercolours might come back. I'm scrubbing. I meant to just put a little puddle on it. Or I might have to lay down a little gentle wash of my gouache permanent white. Now, I was saying the other day about this purist. I find it very, very difficult to come to terms with this sort of thing. As far as I'm concerned, will it do the job? If it would do the job, fine. I'm not too concerned about whether it's pure watercolour or not pure watercolour. This is all about an idea, right? It's not about perfection. It's making this idea visible. Right, I shall let that soak and do that a couple of times, then come back. And when I do, take my word for it, that paper will be dry, naturally. Right, now, I didn't really manage to remove too much of that stain there. So I've still got many options open to me. So what I'm doing is I'm just going to put in the first ice lolly. How come you didn't think about that? I'm waiting for the drop to come down the bottom. I think I'm going to get away with that one. This one is a little bit on the darker side. So I will go for a strawberry. There you go, look, I've got away with it, I'm pretty sure. It hasn't got that lovely translucent look about it, I'll give you that. I need to just demonstrate, if I had not got away with that, what I would have done. Now, first thing, get rid of my palette. No, I've changed my mind. What I'm going to do is, look, I'm going to take a little bit of the, this is now going to be strawberry, and I'm going to put it on my palette. There. Rinse my brush. Put my palette away. Take just a little touch of my permanent white and I'm going to mix it in with that. It was a bit too strong. Mix it in with just a little bit. I'll wash my brush so it's not going to contaminate the paints. A little touch of strawberry, sorry. Now that, by doing that, What I've actually done is I've turned it to what is known as a body colour. In other words, look, it's slightly stronger than the watercolours. And this is a perfectly bona fide thing to do, by the way, because all the Victorian painters, when they were doing English gardens and roses, that's what they use. That's what they put all the floribundi in with. Right, let me see if I've got that. I need to check that, and I'm going to look at the ribbon holding the baby's booty. I've now picked up my white gouache palette. Oh look, I've got a little leaping lamb there. Your palette always comes out a little bit more interesting than what you can paint. In actual fact, you need to look at your palette every now and again, because you can gain an awful lot of information off it when you're not actually concentrating on a particular bit of painting. And what I'm going to do here, I'm going to zoom that back. And what I'm looking at is the ribbon. And the reason I put it down in a wash is because I just heard the camera go off again, so I've managed to switch it back on. I hope it's got some sound on it. Right, there's the ribbon. I'm now looking at the boot, and I'm wondering whether or not to cover all the boot in, which I'm now tempted to do. Let it dry and come back with the blue stripes on it. Look, note, what I'm putting on there is not a solid bit of colour, but it is a wash. If I put a solid bit of colour on there, then I'll be painting on a mound of colour, and I don't want that. So look, it's starting to disappear already. I'm happy with that, because the toe, which comes past into the snow line, will be blue, and the heel will be blue, and I want a couple of sort of stripes to match the baby's bonnet on there. I'm going to now allow that to dry, and when I come back you'll see it's going to be much, much weaker than what it's appearing there at the moment. I'm very sorry about this, folks. They got me again. It would be very, very difficult for me to repaint this sock, but you can see what's going on. Really the same process as I'm very sorry about that, folks. I'm afraid the gremlins got me again. Thank goodness that I sent the other part four away when I did. I put the blue on in a similar way to what I did the bonnet. And what I'm doing now is I'm just adding a little bit of wash. Permanent white. To make the sock a little bit more stripy. And do you know what the great shame is? Because I went and lost this, I actually painted a little robin up there. But the gremlins came along and the robin has flown off. So look, we're going to keep living with what we've got. Well, all I've got to do now is plant this stick. Right, now I'm just going to put a little bit of water at the bottom of that stick. And then I'm going to come back and I'm just going to drop a little bit of wash on it. And it's, look, it's very tight because that's where the stick actually goes into the snow. Pick up a little bit of water and just soften the outer edge. There we go. Right, now I'm going to really let it paint itself now. There we go. And what I will do, I'm also going to put a little bit of snow on this stick, just to make it a little bit more convincing. Right, this is the second time I've done this, or the third time. Look, if you find that little brush very, very difficult, and many people will, look, I'm using a watercolour pencil here, and don't start getting all over proud about or worried about a brush. And look, this is the green. Here we go, make sure it's on the camera. There you go, Gremlins, I bet you'll like this one. There you go, look, you've got berries and holly leaves, exactly as what I've got there, it's just that one's done with a brush and one is not. Right, it does not matter how you get them, as long as you get them. That is assuming that you in actual fact go this far, because you don't have to. This is not everybody's cup of tea. Right, so what I now need to do, oh, I'm going to switch that off before the gremlins grab them. I need to put in the lolly sticks. There we go. I need to bring that sock round there because I can't get a stick on this one. Not to worry, what can I do? Yeah, I can bring a little bit of blue down there at some point. Not right at this moment. I'm going to be grateful for what I've got. But I did say, look, I'm going to put a little bit of snow on this stick to give it that outdoor look. I don't want it to look so somebody's just come along and plunked it on. And then I'm going to use a couple of special effects on the bobble on the baby's bonnet. And I'm going to come back with one or two more ideas, which I'm not saying you're in trouble, but they may help you out if you are, okay? Right, now I have dragged the side of that sock down to get the ice lollies into the sock. I've also added a little bit of blue across there to give a broken appearance, coming back to this white ribbon which I've got at the top there. And I'm now looking at this, the baby's bonnet there. It's got a lovely glow on there, but it is not looking like a fluffy bauble on the top there. It is looking more, if I zoom this back again, look, it's starting to look more as though it could be a bauble on this tree at the back. And it's got that hard edge, so I want to get a little softness around that. And I want to pump it up just a little bit. I might need to whiten the back and drag it up. Now, I've got a number of options on this. I can do the same as what I did on this orange ice lolly down there. And that is using a body colour, in other words, mixing my colour in with the permanent white. But why not, don't go in too heavy. Instead of floating that on and trying to get that gravity drop, I'm going to stipple it on there. So that is the direction I'm going at the moment. Look, I'm also looking at the baby's foot here. It is very confusing because I can't put a knee in there. Sorry. They don't have knees. And in the same way as I had that skeleton look about mum's hand, I've got the same with the foot. So I'm going to use my permanent white and I'm going to make that much more into a snowball foot. What else? Look, that's enough to be getting on with. Oh, I'm coming back to this now. When I actually look at it, yes, I painted it in my mind's eye before I actually painted it onto the paper. And I did have problems because I was going over a drop of shade in here, but I've managed to overcome that. But there is another thing which I tend to think about. I think it might have been nice if the baby stocking had been on the outside and the holly on the inside. It would have been much easier for me to do the holly on the inside. But if I'd put the holly on the inside, it would have acted as a spiky barrier between mum and the hanging sock. Look, I had the area there, I could have got a little bit more glow around there. But look, I'm not going to punish myself for things which I failed to do. And the other thing is, I think this holly here, being that much closer to us, can be a little bit larger and more generous. So that will add or counterbalance some of this heavy colour on the inside. Okay, look, I'm getting a little bit complex here, so I'm going to stop the chat and get on with it. Right, easy bits first. Done. Right, permanent white. And look, just notice, I tend to practice my moves before making contact with the actual paper to make sure that I'm comfortable and I can achieve what I'm setting out to do. There we go. Snowball-y. And I'm just going to highlight the little toe. While I'm at it, I'm now looking at mum's hand again, and that finger, I'm going to add that finger into the snowball. There we go, that's a little better. And so just picking up a bit more paint. And I know she's got I know she's got her eye makeup on and her blusher. But I'm not gonna paint her fingernails. Right, there we go. I'm just going to make her hand a little bit more rounded than what it was. Now, you can accuse me of being fussy here, and maybe I am, but it is within my power. Because in this particular case, and the only particular case, I am her creator. Right, now, one other thing. Look, on that ribbon, that's an interesting one, but I lost it on there, so I'm just going to come back to brighten that side up. And I may be making a mistake here, but it's just a little touch. I'm going to add a little sparkle on the lolly. Just to make it a little more juicy. Now I'm really brush ticking now. Okay, I'm now going to move up to tackle the fluffy bauble. And in order to do that, I'm just going to pump up behind with a little bit of wash in order to help me out on this one, because I need a little bit of help, and I can give myself that little bit of help. Okay, let's just zoom that back and then I need to keep turning this round for you, so that you can see what I'm actually looking at. Nobody else gets this close to my painting, not even my students, those who may be a little bit struggling with their eyesight or sound. Yeah, they'll always be invited up to the front, but they never sit on my lap. The only things what get closer to this is you, because you're viewing it through the camera, and one or two of the fruit flies who get in even that closer. Look, I'm being silly again. Let's get on with this bauble. Right, now I'm about to go, and look, I've got my light red, and I'm going to add a little bit of my gouache to the light red. Do not start with your white and add your red to it, because you will run your pan out very, very fast. So what I want here is I want the darker red to go in, and it will be just a little bit damp, and then I'm going to be using what would be known as my miniaturist tick 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 skills. My voice is all over the place, and then I will speed the whole thing up. I have here a soft pastel. This particular one is called a Conti Crown, and it is a stick form. You can buy a little tin of these, and they're always useful to have around. I'm not going to go into the ins and outs of pastels at this moment, because this is about a watercolour. But I did say earlier on, if you've got a soft pastel and a permanent white, now you're going to know the reason why I suggested the possibility of them. Now, in order to make my moon a little bit more interesting, what I'm going to do is, look, I'm going to the centre source of the light, and I'm just going to put on one or two little moonbeams. Now, don't do it all the way around, leave that little gap. Let me get that in a bit closer. Leave the little gap, because without that gap, you're going to lose the moonbeams. I'm going down towards the trees here, look. And I want to come out towards Mum's hat. So I go back to the light source. My clip's getting in, interfering with my hand. There we go. I go back to the light source, and I take it in a direction I want it to go. Now that is a little bit heavy as a shaft of light, but not to worry. What I will now do is, look, I will clean my finger, put my finger on there, and I will take it out in one swipe the direction I want it to go. Look, there we go. Just clean my finger and down towards Mum's hat. Have you got it there? Right, so I'm come down to the trees. I've got one coming towards Mum's hat, bonnet. I'll just put on a little bit more. Clean my finger, back in one swipe. There we go. A little magical moonlight. Don't panic, I'm not going to break into song. Look, here I've got a more expensive one, and this is a very, very soft pastel here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to use it just to put on little random bits of snow on Mum's hat. And I can use this to hide a multitude of sins, if sins they be. There we go. Because my brush line was a little bit on the hard side, so I've now got a little bit of soft snow. So let's see if I can get that in even closer. There, look, there it is, soft snow. And look, there's my moonbeams. And if I wanted to make them a little bit sharper, I would use this slightly softer pastel. Look, I'm putting it on the moon. And then I'm just one finger out. There we go. The mysterious little moonbeams. I'm going to now check to see if I've got that on there. I'm taking a little bit of this soft pastel, and I'm using my nail to scrape bits up. And the reason I'm using my nail is because I want them random sizes. Right, that is a little pile of pastel dust now. little pile of pastel dust. So what I will do is I will gather them up until I've got enough to pinch, and then I will drop them from a height onto my painting. There we go. Right, let me zoom that in very close now. Now I do know that there's a lot of people, there's my pieces, look, they're random pieces, and I can't just press them in. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a piece of paper over the top, and then I'm going to roll a glass over the top and press them into my painting. I have sprinkled to make sure, piece of paper over the top now, and make sure you do this on a hard surface. And I'm now going to roll them in. Right, here we go again, folks. These gremlins are absolutely ferocious at the moment. They're giving me about 3 or 4 seconds. But look, what you see and what you hear is what you get. Right, so let's see what we've got. Lift off gently. There we have it, folks. A nice little low snow flurry, and I'm going to zoom that in if the camera will allow me to. There we go, look at that. And I deliberately made sure they weren't round the mum's eye and baby's eyes, and I've shifted them away from the moon by just very gently moving them off with a soft brush. Let me see what I've got. Okay, folks, this is what we've got, and this is after a long, strenuous journey, but it has been a labour of love. And I'm going to zoom the camera around this very carefully so that you can have a look at one or two of the bits and pieces. There's no point in me dwelling on the bits that never really worked out too well. I need to focus on the bits which did work out well. And one bit I'm particularly pleased with, and that is the way that stick planted itself into the snow. Or in this case, I planted it into the snow. Look, there's a lovely drop colour just there. I know that it's a bit orange at top, but it's lovely. And look, there's another one on there. And the little fluffy bubble turned out well. And look, there's another nice little drop on there. Now, okay, look, there are some little holes and little bits and pieces. Looks like an earring on there. But I'm not going to go in and really tighten this all down, because I don't want it to look like a professional card. I want it to look like a watercolour. And before I say any more, I'm just going to switch this one off to make sure I've got it. Right, just when I thought I'd finished, I just got a message from Mum. She, inasmuch as she appreciates that I've left some nice little ice lollies for her baby, he hasn't really got a mouth in which to eat them with. So I've just added a little bit more weight to the mouth. There you go, Mum. Yes, I managed to get that last little clip. Look, just if you've really struggled with that washer in the background and you're not happy with it, look, or even around the laha, look, here's a little circular paper mount I've put around there. you can use a compass, or in this particular case, although I do have a compass, I in actual fact used my water bowl and just made sure it was dry, turned it upside down, drew around it. I went round with a knife because I can, but I do know that the ladies are not so hot with a knife, but they're whiz kids with their little nail scissors, so you can cut it out like that. But look, if you're one of these hairy blokes, a knife. Now, I still have a lot more to say about this, and I don't know what to call this one, because it has been one of the most unusual of watercolour tutorials. It has been very long, it's almost been an epic. I'm reaching a point where I can almost describe it as the watercolour musical. That's if I was a little bit more au fait with my music. But whatever you come up with, and it may be very, very humble, like my singing, it is open and it is honest, and friends will appreciate it. And so if you send whatever it is, look, it could be a snow baby, providing mum's head is not completely fallen off, or she's dropped the baby. Your friends will see it as what it is. It is a little window into your imperfect soul. And your friends will know that, because your friends, they're not perfect. Because if they were perfect, you wouldn't be their friend, because perfect people do not actually have friends. They only have acquaintances who they can barely tolerate. So feel free, feel relaxed, and print whatever it is you've got and send it on your emails. Or I'm now going to show you what you can do with it if you scan it and print it. I have taken that little image there and I've printed it out onto a sheet of computer paper, which I can now fold in half. Fold it once again. And there you have it, folks. A very simple little Christmas card. Now, if you'd rather, you can always cut it out and adhere it to a piece of card. And if you do choose to do that, then I would suggest that do not go and use a water-based adhesive, but get yourself one of these little dry glue sticks, which you can get from your local post office or hardware store. Right, now we are rapidly running out of time, so I'm just gonna close this one down, because I've got a very impatient mumsy snow person who's now visible, and she wants to globe trot and show her little baby around the world. However, she needs to be just a little bit patient, even though, look, we've got Dad outside kicking up the snow and jumping for joy, because I've still got one or two things I need to say to you. Firstly, I would like to thank you for joining me in my watercolour pool, my fantasy watercolour pool, and I can only hope that that I've given you one or two little hooks to hang onto when your gremlins of self-doubt get the better of you. Just remember, it is not about being brush perfect. painting is about feelings and emotions. So whatever they are, when you go back to your own pool, keep them simple, like that little song I sang. It is not a long piece, it is simple and not over complex, and you need to keep your art simple, not too complex. Don't start going off thinking you're going to do marketplaces and things like that, because you'll drown. So simple is the word, and if you can enjoy the act of painting, the rest will follow in its own good time. Now I'm going to give you one last little zoom around this picture before I press the button and off she goes. So let's do that now. I will try and hold this steady for you, but I'm zoomed in very close and I'm moving the picture around. Look, I quite like that little bubble. I find that quite convincing and quite exciting. And the nice thing is, it's now different to the baby's button nose. I'm going to move that down because I love this little bit of snow and the way the stick stuck into the snow there. Now there are bits, I'm not going to like everything, one never does. You've got to look at the overall effect which you're actually getting. Now look, I'm moving back up, and you can freeze this at any moment you want to on your video. I'm now back to this little moon. And this you may know or may not know. That little song I sang is in actual fact an old English nursery rhyme. And it may well be that you've got your own baby, or you've got your own grandchildren, and you might just find yourself singing it to them. If not to them, next time you see that moon, I get the feeling you might just sing it to yourself. Oh dear, this old boy, there's no end to him. Right, I know there's going to be one or two out there who's going to turn and say, hey, what about that snow on the stick? He's forgotten it. Well, to be quite honest, yes, I had. So I put the snow on the stick and I went off and had a cup of tea and relaxed, feeling much better about myself. And would you believe, when I came back, our little friend the robin had returned, because there were no camera gremlins. And not only has he returned, look, he's actually brought the berries back with him. Now it's a strange, strange world, folks. There you go. I have just one more small thing which I can add to that baby's stocking before I send them off zooming around the world. And what else? A rattle. Bye bye, folks. Let's all have a peaceful night. Thank you.
Have a very peaceful and happy Christmas, my Facebook friends. 'Cause I loves you. Yeah.